Hey everyone, in this video we're going to take a look at the animation pipeline between iClone and MotionBuilder. Regardless of the motion data or control rig you're using, it has never been easier to work together with both programs, which makes for a quick and efficient workflow for either yourself or a team. Let's start off with a common workflow, which is exporting an FBX from iClone. You'll want to export your T-pose first, which is an essential part of the retargeting. Since we're working with MotionBuilder in this tutorial, please choose that as a target tool preset. After that, export once again with the frame range of your animation. Now that we've exported the necessary FBX files, let's import them into MotionBuilder. You'll want to start off by opening up the T-pose FBX file. From there, go over to Define your skeleton and create a control rig. For skeleton definition, choose CC Worker from the available templates and define it as a biped character. Once that's all set, then you can go over to Motion File Import and select the Motion FBX you exported from iClone. Here's a quick preview of our motion. From there, you want to go over and bake the control rig and choose the FK-IK option. Once the animation has been baked to the control rig, then you can go ahead and tweak the animation at various points in the timeline in MotionBuilder. Here I'm just doing some very simple tweaking by setting some keys in the animation layer. Okay, if you're satisfied with the edits you've made in MotionBuilder, then you can also export the edited motion back to iClone via FBX. To do so, simply go over to your character control, and this time choose Bake to Skeleton, since we're going to export. From there, choose Motion File Export, and you only need to select the motion data that you're using. Finally, let's look at some common motion editing tools in iClone. I'll start by holding the Control key and clicking and dragging to duplicate my character, and then with the duplicate character selected, import the FBX motion that we exported from MotionBuilder. The motion file will be detected automatically, and here we'll want to ensure that we assign the same T-pose in the import options. You'll notice the changes I've made upon playback, and you can use the Zero Out button in the Attributes tab to get the duplicated character in the exact same starting position for a more noticeable difference regarding the edits we've made in Mobu. In iClone, we can use features like the Edit Motion Layer tool to tweak the animation even further. Here I'm toggling IK mode, and then locking the feet and chest control points so that we can freely move the hip from left to right with each step without affecting the contact points for the feet or the orientation of the upper body. That's just a quick and easy example of one of iClone's motion editing tools. Please feel free to visit our Real Using Courses page to get more info on the multitude of other useful features that you can take advantage of to enhance your motion editing pipeline. That's it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.